Well, it's been 46 days since House Republicans first passed a bill to keep the government open and put us on a fiscally sustainable path. The President of the United States has just said the least we can do is pass a budget, and then went to Pennsylvania apparently to work on his campaign budget. We would remind the President again, House Republicans have passed a bill to keep the government open and put the nation on a fiscally sustainable path. We stand here today united with the Path to Prosperity budget introduced by our Budget Committee Chairman Paul Ryan. The nation has an opportunity to be on the path to decline or the path to prosperity. Under the Republican budget, we will prevent tax increases, provide fundamental tax reform, and we will provide the nation with a fiscally sustainable path to give the confidence to job creators to go out and grow, invest, and create more jobs in America. That's what we need today, and we haven't seen anything but a protection of the status quo of spending borrowing 42 cents on the dollar, much of it from the Chinese, and sending the bill to our children and grandchildren. That is simply unacceptable.
You know, I've got to tell you all that I like the President personally. We get along well. But the President isn't leading. He didn't lead on last year's budget, and he clearly is not leading on this year's budget. You've got to remember that the Democrats had a majority here last year, super majorities in the House and Senate. They had the White House, and yet they failed to pass a budget. Matter of fact, they couldn't even agree on the budget after the election. And in December, they just punted until this month. When you look at the fact that the President introduced a bill to put a debt commission together a year ago, and while I didn't agree with everything his debt commission put forward, I'm going to tell you what, these people really worked hard. And they had a lot of very good ideas, and yet the President used none of his own deficit reduction commission's ideas in his own budget. Here we are trying to clean up last year's mess. Our goal is real clear. We're going to fight for the largest spending cuts we can get and the policy writers that were attached to them because we believe that cutting spending will lead to a better environment for job creation. We're continuing to have conversations with our colleagues in the Senate. I'm hoping that they'll continue to go well. But the government's due to shut down tomorrow. So we're going to be prepared to move forward with our troop funding bill that would fund our troops, keep the government open for another week, and cut $12 billion in spending. I think this is the responsible thing to do for the United States Congress, and I would hope the Senate could pass it and the President would sign it into law.
Obviously, these are very serious times for this country. As we know, $14 trillion in debt is no light matter. I care about people. We care about people. We care about people who are out there right now trying to find a job. We care about people who, frankly, are trying to figure out how they get through the end of the month trying to pay the bills. And that's why we are doing what we're doing. We have got to solve the debt crisis in this country. And we have got to demonstrate some responsibility here in Washington so this economy can get going again. As we all know, Paul Ryan and the Budget Committee are marking up the budget as we speak. You know, we have put forward a plan that, in fact, does retire the debt over time and does so without raising taxes. We've seen nothing out of the President as far as a vision for how he wants to take this country. And in fact, in the Senate, we know from the leader there, he doesn't even accept that there is a fiscal crisis in this country. You know, we believe that we've got to act to do something to make sure that the American economy recovers. We have put forward plans. We understand America is broke. And my question is, Mr. President, are you going to help us fix it?
You know, it's been said that past behavior is the best indication of a future behavior. If you look, when the Democrats were in the majority, they never produced a budget. Republicans came into power, they produced one that took you all the way to the end of the year. 46 days, the same past behavior, is their behavior today. After we first extended for the first 2 weeks, the president got engaged, sent the vice president down. Lo and behold, he spent one day and left for 2 weeks. After we extended again, and now we're at another deadline, the president called people down. Lo and behold, he left again today. I think this election was a different election. This election was about change. But it was more than just change. It was a cultural change of Washington. They expect things to be fact-based and to actually solve problems. Think for 1 minute, or only imagine, what the future could be if the debt was taken away. What could you spend that interest money on? What could you invest in for America? Well, we've imagined what it could be, and we're going to fight for it. And we ask people to do the job they're supposed to do. If the Senate could only have taken the last 46 days and passed something, we'd be in a much different position. And we ask the Senate to change their past behavior and change the actions where America could go.
There's not a single House Republican that wants to shut down the government, and we've been doing everything we can to avoid it. And just some numbers to prove it. 46, that's the number of days ago that we passed H.R. 1. Zero, that's the amount of work that the Senate has done on the budget. 45,000, that is the debt for every single American in this country. $90,000, that's the debt projected over the next 10 years. The House Republicans are committed to bringing our fiscal house in order. We've taken those steps. We passed a budget that would take us back to those pre-bailout, pre-stimulus levels. And we are committed to getting this fiscal house in order, and we ask the Senate to take the action necessary to allow us to move forward.
American people in November spoke clearly. They want serious, serious answers to the serious problems the country faces. And the Republican majority that took over in January has presented those time and again and are doing so as the budget's being marked up today. It's time to get on with the big issues. But we're going to make sure our troops are paid as we resolve the spending issues. We've got to cut spending. That's what American people said. They don't want these deficits passed on to the next generation. It's time for the Senate to act. It's time for the Senate to get serious. And then we get this resolved and moved on to the big issues.